everybody, and welcome to Junior Church. I'm so glad to see your smiling faces. I'm so glad to see that you are excited to be here. I'm excited to be here. We're going to have a great time together tonight. But before we get started, we have just four simple rules for you. Everybody say four. Everybody hold up your four. This is four. All right. So, rule number one is to have fun. We want you to have fun in Junior Church because church is fun. We get together to dance and to sing to the Lord, to praise His name. It's so much fun. Number two, we need you to participate. You can't have fun if you're not participating. You can't have fun if you're not getting involved and doing everything you can. And most importantly, your friends can't see it. Speaking of your friends, make sure you go down and you like, comment, and share this video. We want to know what you're doing, where you're from, all that kind of stuff. We want everybody to see it. So share it so that your friends can see it too. All right. So rule number three is that no distractions. So if you've got toys, put them away. If you've got games, put them away. If you've got a book other than your Bible, go ahead and just put it away. We want to focus all of our attention on God tonight. We want to learn something that He has for us here tonight. And rule number four is when it's time for altar call, there's no playing in the altar, only praying. So no playing, just praying. So remember that. Rule number one is to have fun. Exactly. Rule number two, participate. Yes. Rule number three, no distractions. Put away everything else but God. And then rule number four, no playing when it's altar call, just praying. All right. So, but before we go into our action songs, it's time for us to go over our memory verse.
Are you ready to learn your Bible verse? I know that I am. It goes like this. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusts in thee. Psalms 84:12. So let's learn it all together. First, we're going to make an L with our right hand, and we're going to start at our left shoulder and cross our body to our right hip. Lord, O Lord. Good job. Do that with me one more time. Oh, Lord. Good job, everybody. And then we're going to say, of host. We're going to look like an army. Our right hand on the top, our left hand on the bottom. And we're going to pull that. Imagine that you have a sword or armor in front of you that you're pulling in. Of host, because host is an army. And God is the God over all the armies that protect you and me. Yes, He is. So, O Lord of hosts. Can we do that together? O Lord of hosts. One more time. O Lord of hosts. Good job. The next part is blessed is. Thumbs up for good job. Blessed is. One more time. Blessed is. So let's put the beginning in that together. Here we go. One, two, three. O Lord of hosts, blessed is, and then you're going to come back with your thumb from where you are and point to yourself, the man, meaning mankind, man, woman, boy, girl, blessed is the man, blessed is the man. Good job. Let's put it all together. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man, then we're going to say that trust. Going to keep your hand in a fist and you're going to hold it with this other one like somebody's holding on to you. You trust them. That trust in thee. And you're going to point up to God. That trust in thee. One more time. That trust in thee. So let's put it all together. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusts in thee. And where is it found? Psalms 84:12. Can you say that with me? Psalms 84:12. One more time. Psalms 84:12. So let's put all those parts together. One, two, three. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusts in thee. Psalms 84:12. Good job, everybody. Let's say it one more time. Really loud with all of your emotions. I want to hear you. One, two, three. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusts in thee. Psalms 84:12. Great job, everybody.
So simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah. I don't gotta be afraid no more, no. 'Cause I know you up and through the storm. I'm more than just a talker. I'm a wave walker. I'm dancing on water. When the devil tries to shake me, I just pray.
Songs. I see all your bodies moving. You guys exhausted? Well, let's now calm our bodies and let's go ahead and transition to a time of prayer. Our focus prayer today is our elders. How many of you have grandparents? We all love our grandparents, right? What about our elders in our church? Some of you might know some of them. That's right. Paul Batten, Granny Poole, Brother George. That's right, Sister Doris. And Sister Pate, man, I hear all these different names. That's awesome. Well, let's go ahead and pray for them today. Don't forget our four steps of prayer. Are you ready? Our hands up, our head up, with our eyes closed and our outdoor voices. Lord, we come before you right now, Lord. Bring in our elders, God. Lord, I ask, God, Lord, that you keep them, Lord. Lord, wherever they are, Lord, I ask, God, Lord, that you meet them in that place, Lord, and let them feel your loving arms wrap them, Lord, right now, God. Lord, I ask, God, during this time, Lord, I ask, Lord, that you put your hedge of protection over them, Lord, and keep them safe, Lord, and keep their families safe. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. That was great. Now let's go ahead and get ready for worship.
Thank you.
In a moment, I'm going to ask you to raise your hand and close your eyes. And in that moment, I just want you to speak to God as if he's right in front of you. Okay?
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are.
You are great.
You are here, touching every heart. I worship
God, you.
God,
you are powerful.
I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you.
Going. Oh, awesome. I heard a lot of goods, fantastics, absolutely wonderful, amazing. Yeah, my Sunday is going absolutely amazing, and I am so glad that I can be with you today. So today we're going to continue our series on superheroes. Can you do your super stance in 3, 2, One. Awesome, super stance. Everybody put your hand up, turn it around, pat yourself on the back and say, "Ooh, I'm good." So today we're gonna talk about someone who was a leader. Or maybe it was someone that followed the leader. Have you ever played Follow the Leader?
Yay!
Yeah, it's kind of like Simon Says. Everyone go ahead and stand up. We're gonna play Simon Says. Simon Says, touch your head. Simon Says, touch your knees. Touch your elbows. Oh, some of you are out. I see you. Simon Says, touch your ear. Simon Says, make a funny face. Simon Says, touch your nose. Simon Says, touch your ears. Simon Says, touch your nose. Simon Says, touch your ears. Touch your nose. Oh, I got some of you. Everyone can sit down. That was an awesome job playing Simon Says. Wow, y'all are really good at this. So we're gonna continue our series on the superhero, and we're gonna have something to do with leaders, following a leader, maybe being a leader. Why are leaders important? I mean, why are they important? Well, who was the leader of the Avengers in the comic books? Right, Captain America. And who was the leaders of Guardians of the Galaxy? Right, Star-Lord. So why do they need a leader? If all of them are superheroes and all of them have some amazing superpower, why do they need a leader? You know what I think? I think that they're all team players. And because they all play on the same team, they need one person to lead them so that other people, they don't go separate ways, right? It says that we are better together than we are separate. How many of you agree with that? That if you're playing on a football team or you have friends, that you're better together, right? Slumber parties are much better when we're all at the same house rather than quarantine when we all have to be on Zoom. Yeah, same thing. We are better together than we are separate. Can you say that with me? We're better together than we are separate. So today we're gonna learn about our superhero, Mr. Obedience. Can you do that with me? Hand on hip. Other hand in the sky, look up, and we gotta say, Mr. Obedient. You ready? One, two, three. Mr. Obedient. Mr. Obedient had a great faith. He followed God's command. Who in the Bible followed God's command? Do you know anyone? Yeah, there were a lot. I mean, there were a lot, but this guy really stuck out. I wonder why this guy really, really stuck out. Let's read in Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 through 4. And you can go ahead and stand for this since it's super short. Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 through 4. And remember, we stand during the reading of the word because that's how important God's word is to us. So we're going to read Genesis 12, chapter 1 through 4. I made oopsie daisies. Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 through 4. Now the Lord had said unto Abram, "Get thee out of thy country and from the kindred and from thy father's house unto a land which I'll show you. And I will make of thee a great nation. And I will bless thee and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless you and curse him that curses you. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed." So Abram departed, as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him. And Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. Wow. That was really short. You can put your Bibles down. So God said, Abram. Can you sing Abram? Abram. Can you say it really softly? Abram. Can you say it like Frankenstein? Abram. Abram. Abram was this man, and you'll later know him as Abraham. Do y'all know who Abraham is? Yeah. So before he was Abraham, his name was Abram. And Abram was just walking along one day. Can you walk with me? Walk, 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 walk. And God said, Abram, you're going to move. And you're going to leave your family and the place that you were born and you've lived and you've been raised and you went to high school and college. You're going to move. And I'm not going to tell you yet, but I'll show you when you get there where you're supposed to be. So what did Abram do? You know what? I think he said, why, God, why me? Why?
No!
Oh, he didn't do that? No. You're right. He said, God, I'm not doing that.
No!
Oh. He didn't do that either? Okay, he probably said, God, you know what? I will do it, but maybe just not right now. I have, you know, a birthday party to go to next week that I kind of got to go. It's my niece. Oh, he didn't do that either. Huh. What did he do? You're right. God said go, and he went. It was just that simple. God said go. So he said, okay. He packed a little bag, threw it over his shoulder, and started walking out of his country. He said bye to his family. Bye, family. And he went. You know, there's very few people in the Bible or ever to have followed God's calling like that. God said go, and he went. He didn't ask questions. He didn't hesitate. Do y'all know what hesitate means? So it's like we're in a conversation and then I hesitate. Did you see that? That was really cool. I'm really good at it. Y'all want to hesitate with me? You ready? And have your hands like this, hands like this, going in a circle. And when I count to one, you're going to pause and then start back up again. Okay, you ready? Hesitation in 3, 2, 1, hesitate. Good job. So hesitation is a slight pause. It's like, God, okay. He didn't do that. He just went, packed his things, said goodbye, and left. That's pretty amazing. You know, even Jonah didn't do that. God said, Jonah, you're going to go over here. You know what Jonah did? You're right. Jonah packed his things, said bye to his family, and went in the complete other direction from where God was calling him. Mary didn't even do that. Mary said, angel, are you sure? Remember, Sarah laughed. So there's a lot of people in the Bible, and not as many did exactly what Abram did. He said, I'll go. You know, he trusted God without questioning or without hesitation. He trusted God. And you know, obedience, it doesn't come naturally to us, right? That means when we're born, we learn how to say, hey, mom, I know you said do this, but I'm playing this video game. And we learn to say, hey, mom, I know I'm supposed to clean my room. I already did it. But you're lying. That's what comes naturally to us. Not saying, yes, mom, I will do it right away. Let me drop everything. Let me not lie. Let me not cheat. Let me not blame it on my sister. Let me go straight to my room right now, this very instant that you asked me, and clean my room from the bottom to the top and scrub all the ceilings. Right? We don't naturally do that. It's kind of hard for us. How many of you, it's hard for you to say, yes, mom, I'll do it right now when she asks you to do something? Even me, and I'm 23 years old, and I don't even live with my mom. But when I'm over there, it's still hard for me because obedience doesn't come naturally to us. That's why we gave Abram the name of Mr. Obedient. Because he went without questioning God, saying, God, why? My family's here. I don't want to go to a land that you haven't shown me yet. My niece and my nephew are here. He didn't question God. He didn't say, but wait. He just went. And he really, really trusted God's plan for his life. And you know what? If you and I trusted God's plan with our that he has for our lives, then we would obey him just like Abram did. If we really trusted that he had our best interest in mind, that means that he's going to make sure we're good. If we really trusted that he made sure we were good at all times, then we wouldn't be afraid to do some things, like talk to that person that's sitting alone all by themselves at the lunch table, or invite our friends to the church because now we're afraid that they're going to say no and think of us a little weird. We wouldn't be afraid when Sister Shelby asked them to pray for the offering. If we really, really trusted God's plan, we would obey at all times. And you know what? I know I wasn't really obeying that much last week, the week before that, or even today much. But you know what I can do? I can take this lesson and be like Abraham. I can say, you know what, God? I wasn't like Abraham yesterday, and I didn't obey the day before that. But you know what, God? I understand this message, and I'm going to do it starting right now. God, I'm going to obey you. And whatever your plan is for my life, I'll obey that too. Even if I don't know what country I'm supposed to go to, just like Abram. Even if I don't know what exactly I'm supposed to say when I go and talk to the person at the lunch table. But I'll do it. Because God, I trust you. I trust your plan. And because of that, I'll be Mrs. Obedient. Just for you. I won't ask why. I won't hesitate. I'll trust you. How many of you can say, you know what? I wasn't obeying yesterday or the day before that or the 23 years before that, but you know what? I'm gonna obey starting right now, and I'll obey tomorrow too. How many of you can say that? Me too. So what is God asking you? What is God asking that you obey? Maybe it's that you should obey God's word. And his word says to repent, to be baptized in Jesus' name, and to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Because remember, you have to be born of spirit and of water. Or he may be asking you to spend 5 extra minutes with him in prayer. Will you obey that today? Or maybe he's saying, you know what? You've been kind of mean to your parents. You haven't really told them you love them lately. Maybe you should go do that. Will you obey him? Will you listen? Will you do what God is asking you to do today? So everyone go ahead and stand and go to your altar. We're going to lift our hands. We're going to close our eyes. We're going to lift our head, and we're going to use our outside voice. We're going to say, God, whatever you're asking of me, God, if you're asking me to go talk to someone, if you're asking me to invite someone to church, God, if you're wanting me to be filled with the Holy Ghost, you know what? I'm going to seek the Holy Ghost today. I'm going to be baptized in Jesus' name today. God, I'm going to repent for my sins today. So we're going to say, God, whatever you're asking of me, I'm willing. So with every hand lifted and every eyes closed and every head up and with every outside voice, God, I thank you for this message. God, I thank you for reminding me, God, that at all times I should be obedient. God, at all times I should listen to what you have to say. God, and I should actually do it. Just like Abram in the story, God, he didn't ask you any questions. He didn't say, God, why must I do this? God, I don't want to do this. He didn't hesitate. He didn't pause. He didn't take a time out. God, he went. He went. He had an unquestionable faith in me. And God, I pray today over myself and over every viewer that you put in us an unquestionable obedience. God, a faith that is able to withstand all things. God, no matter what you ask of us, whether it's to go talk to a stranger, God, I'll go. God, whether it's to say I'm sorry to a friend because I made them upset, God, I'll say sorry. God, if it's to raise my hands and to let the tears fall and be filled with the Holy Ghost and speak in a language that I don't know, God, I'm willing because that is what your word says. And God, I will obey your word at all times, in all seasons, and for all reasons. God, I pray right now over those that are lifting up their hands, God, and are willing to be used. God, that are seeking after your plan in their lives. God, no matter what you ask of me, no matter what your word says, God, I will obey it. God, and your word says to obey my parents, so I'm going to obey my parents. God, your word says be baptized in Jesus' name, so I'm going to be baptized in Jesus' name. God, your word says to be nice, so I'm going to be nice. And God, I've made mistakes last week and even today, but God, starting right now, right where I am, God, I'm going to obey you. God, those things that I said to my mom or about my mom, God, I'm sorry for that. Because you said to honor your parents. So I'm going to honor my mom. I'm going to honor my dad. God, I pray right now for those that feel like they need to pray 5 more minutes a day. Those that you're calling to talk to you a little bit. God, I pray over them. God, I pray that your hand follows them. God, that before they go and they lay themselves down to sleep, God, I pray that they are remembered of this. God, of this commitment that you placed in their heart. God, that yes, they will pray 5 extra minutes. Even though we make mistakes and even though we mess up, God, 5 minutes. God, I will obey your word. God, I will follow your plan. God, I will be misobedient, just like Abram. God, I thank you for today. Can't wait for the rest of this week. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. If you're praying, continue to pray. If not, I will see you back here on Wednesday.
Yes, we do, Lord. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender.
I surrender all.
I surrender.
One more time with hands lifted, won't you cry?